My tongue trips on language, making out which voice is mine. Here, alone in the room, talking to everybody at once. Which voice do you choke in which company? And when there's none? We never lived in abandoned buildings. Never rode abandoned rails. Highways full of us and alleys. Narratives left behind for stories told, but lived too, as well as can in between what passes for words these days. Sentence shares its etymology with sensuous, but also with sentiment. We being we never knew, but lived like that anyway. All our language, all we had to bind us. That and love, that and always danger, and hunger. Every kind of hunger you could ever want, driving us to do nothing that would be rendered human by the towns we passed and hid under. Drinking water from the tap around back, wine from bags, dirt from every pore. Still looking for the noise that cracks out the walls of signal. The one that tells you who I am when you know, and where it is I'm going. Noise music for noise people, to keep those other ears from listening. Every speech a poem, every body a place to live, in spite of what they tell you is only right, because that shit is nothing but death, and you know it. So what now? We getting older, some, others falling, fast or fallen. One eye in many worlds today. The sweat on my skin boiling out of stranger airs to cover me in anxieties and stomach ache. It is a sickness to be far from home and strange in every country. Too many dead to hold you down, not enough life left to breathe. I want to bring you flowers, like one of those times I was dying. Erase my tattoos with expensive medicines and call me someone new. I just want to hold you, generic you, any you who knows my other names, who's seen my eyes move in different direction. I'll strike myself with sugar, the last drug left to sleep for minutes in the empty beds we've made. Emotional Rescue is a pretty dull song, but good and sentimental to know right now, right here, driving home through hate and general excess. My only ambition is to be, not become. My only want, to eat food inside for another few years before the bills come due. We are birds before the earthquake, animals in storm. All our eyes twitching in unison to the sound of. Isolation, loneliness, lonesomeness, an extreme lack loss of intimacy in my life has fundamentally rewired my perceptions of the worlds, internal and external alike. I am, at some very real level, not who I was before this decade began. It is impossible, standing in this new skin, to know whether or not this is a good, bad, or neutral thing. I still have what appears to me to be the same long days of depression, the same shining hours of joy. But how would I know if they really are the same? Even under the best of conditions, memory is an inaccurate map, erased and rewritten with each breath it takes, and more between the breaths, the ones we hold, the ones we let go. But these are not ideal conditions. Isolation creates a kind of echo in the mind that distorts, a fading that grows, more insistent as it goes, becomes more concrete and unalterable. Without other voices to converse, to comment, to cohabit with, the too many voices that argue and dance inside each of us, it is only our own misapprehensions that build on. Loneliness and lack of intimacy have likewise been proven, though to be sure it was true before the proofs were invented, to poison perceptions, to bend the mind's ability to think back on itself until it is a closed loop of dark misinformation. So where I can recognize that I must be other than I was, I can't say how or why or what or to what purpose or ends that change is made. I know, though, that I am scared. I know that I will continue until. I died here once or twice, in different bodies than this one. But the flesh that carries me now sometimes remembers what the flesh that carried me then remembered of itself and others. I can smell the street with my eyes closed, before the rain, after the dirty snow had gone, deep in spring. Old coat, dirty socks, last night hanging around my tongue like the same story again. So today on that same block I miss Marcus, I miss Dave, I miss Arak. And I miss even the ones who are still here, and the thousands more who aren't. I wish we had lived to see the day could be ours again, with not less but different pains to bother us. So many memories and even more we can't remember, said song to me and back again, haha, no doubt. after the picture. And that's what made this poem come here now to stay.